Hey guys, it's Clinton D'Souza and I'm back with another edition of Sports Encounter with me, only on Goa 365. Today, I'll be speaking to a legend, a woman who has made her name across the world. She's none other than Maimal Rocky, who is the A-certified coach and the head coach of the Indian women's team. Let's see to what she has to say. So, I have with me the senior football team's, India's senior football team's head coach, that is Maimal Rocky. First of all, ma'am, congratulations and welcome to Goa 365. Thank you for giving us your time speaking to us. So I would firstly like to, how you said that I have read about you and I've also seen lots of your interviews. I personally, being a man, I'm anyways your fan because you have taken that girl power, that she power head. So first of all, tell me what motivated you to come into football, because first you were in athletics, then you came into football. So I want to know how about that change came in you to enter football.
First of all, like when I was athlete, everybody knows about it.
Yes.
And slowly, because of my brother, it is because he was very keen about football and he was interested. And so in the house, there was always a ball and he should play. So I should think, why should not I? And then my coaches definitely encouraged me to play football for the school and things. And then I started, soon I got into the state team and soon with the national team. So for me, the sports, football was, I think, a smooth pathway for me where I could succeed in my career.
Being a woman, we have not seen too many women out there who are opting to go into sports. Like, do you feel that there was some kind of there was something that you feared of to enter, because football is mainly known as a men sports? So how about as being a woman entering into a sport that is dominated mostly by the men?
For me, when I started, I never knew who's dominating, what is it about, and who will have a career, or I will have a career in this. I just started football just because of my family. As I said, my dad was very interested, my brother was very interested. So for me, it was like, what is in the house, just to play and see. I never thought I will get into the national team or state team or anything. Just started playing. I think it was the love for the game. I never knew how. To tell you the truth, I had hardly seen any football matches before I started playing and things. So then later on, I wanted to learn more. I started watching more. I started going for coaching and all that. But before, it was just the house, what was happening. I think everything starts at home. So that's the truth.
Yeah, basically, if you go to see your social life also, I think when I was doing proper research and all, we have seen that most of your friends are more into football or more into sports. Is it that is why you went into the field of sports?
I think I made a lot of friends when I came to football. That's the truth. Earlier, it was all school friends who were never into sports. So it was only me who was an athlete or sports person in the group where I have friends. But then whatever friends I have now, it's mostly all footballers who are related to football, for sure.
Yes. We have also seen that you have lots of your colleagues who used to play with you. So how was that atmosphere? Because it was at home also you have football. When you go out also it is football, and your social life was also more about football. So how was it that you are more interested in only football than any other sport?
In fact, I was an athlete before, as you know. But then that time I think I was not that matured enough to know what is it about and things. But as soon as I took football as a playing in my career, I think I made a lot of friends in football, and everybody around me, I choose to have football people, I think, because I never thought I will make a career into it. But then, yes, I wanted to be around football and meet all football people. I should get crazy to watch matches, or maybe I-League matches or any third division matches also. I should just love to go and watch. So I think it was my choice to make friends or make colleagues or to choose football people around me.
Well, in the year 2000, you began your career in football. But simultaneously, you also went ahead to do your licensing. You start with your D, then with C, B, and also going up to the highest achievement as doing an A license also. So what motivated you to come into or take something in the license? Made you go in that path?
In fact, when I was playing only, I had one of my coach, I think he's well known, his sister Pais, he's from Vasco. So he was the one who should tell me, like, no, education and sports go in hand in hand. Yeah. Earlier we should think, no, we don't need to study. So you should tell me, no, you should do licensing. I think through him and Savio Masai, sir, who is from Vasco, who was DFA yes. secretary, because I should go with the state team as manager earlier. I should never go as a coach because I didn't have any licenses. So I think these two people who are, like, told me, like, you should do that and you should, go ahead with your coaching career. So it was just to, get into the state team and travel with the team. Mainly, if you see, it's traveling. I should just love traveling because I think my parents could not afford to put me in a flight or train or bus. So I think once I got into sports, everything was free. So I should think, I should do more and more and more.
Yeah, but no matter you said financial reasons and all of those answers you gave, but that support, but still that you got that support from your family, right?
That's true.
Okay, so how was it? Now you went, I will come back to your coaching thing only. So you went into the license of D, then you went into CBA. Which was the toughest one for you? Was it the A or was it the D because you were entering into the licensing?
I think it was D because I'll tell you the truth, we had almost 7 instructors. All the topmost coaches, like Sir Savio Madeira, Derek Sir, Marian Sir, Peter Wallace, who else? There were 7 people, like 7 coaches who had passed out that time A license, and they introduced D license for us in Goa. So I was the only female in that group. But we had 7 topmost instructors who were taking this D license. So you can imagine how difficult it was for me to clear it. But nevertheless, all the coaches and instructors were so helpful. And so they really motivated me. If you see, really, these coaches who are there at the highest point, they actually motivated me to go ahead. And I should definitely, I'll name those 7 coaches. And they are the best, I think, who are in Goa. And they are at the top level. And I think they were the ones who really encouraged me to do. Yeah, but it was tough for me to get through and pass for sure.
Then coming back with your national team, you represented the country almost, I think, 3+ times. So what was the best moment representing that time?
I think I played under-19, which was held in Goa. That time it was directly AFC Championship. So which was held in Goa, I remember. And I scored a goal against Guam team. So I think that was the best moment for me, scoring a goal and playing for the national team and playing first 11. Seniors, it was difficult because all these Manipuris were dominating those years as a national team. Because I remember I should play, it was 15 girls from Manipur and 5 from different states. So it should be very difficult for us to play and things. But I remember under-19 I played and I played first 11. And I remember my mom had come to see the match for the first time and I got a yellow card versus South Korea. So I think I will never forget that under-19 tournament which was held in Goa.
Okay. So how was it? I'll be back on that. I think when I started off this session, you took the women's football to another level. Because we have seen in the past history that the women's team in India were doing good, but they were not on that bench, you see, because when you came back, there were lots of changes that they were witnessed, and there were more of winning waves that India saw. So what were the changes that made India come back to the winning waves?
I think mainly it's believing in that, especially the girls. I think once we qualified for the second round of Olympic qualifiers, round 2, for the first ever time, I think after that, federation or the government, everybody had a support. They said, what do you want, you name. So I had a plan which I gave it to the federation, and federation never said no, because we were preparing for like 4 months, the girls were together, and I think that was the best when somebody believes in the in you or in the national team. So I think then on we had the full support from the federation and the government. So I think, and the girls only had a thing like an opportunity to get through. I think if you see in 2019, we have played more than 35 international matches.
Yes.
So you can, in the history of women's football, I think this is the first ever time like the girls have played for this right through. And the credit definitely goes to the girls because they are the ones who worked hard for it. We had a plan. All the coaches have a lot of plans and a lot of things. in their mind. But it's finally the girls who need to do it and show it on the field. So I think definitely I'll give the credit to the girls who have really taken football to another level. But never forgetting the staff. The staff what I had was amazing. The people who I work with, I make sure they are there with me. And, you know, they are there with the girls team almost 24/7. So that was the best. I think the staff was all ready to do anything at any time of the day and night. And I think that was the best moment. What finally, if you see the results coming out, it's just not within a day you cannot get a result, or within a month you cannot get a result. So if you see the whole year, yes, definitely. If you see the last tournament what we played was SAF, and before that we played Vietnam team. We drew with them 1-1 the last match. Those were the best moment at the last what we could cherish till now at least. And I don't know when we will start again, but yes, so far so good. The team is doing well.
How would you rate the football when it comes to women and the men? How would you differentiate?
I don't need to differentiate. I think women have a different level of play. Men have a different level of play. The game is loved differently. But I can just say that we are also doing I think we are also doing the best. I think whatever the girls can do for the national team, they are giving the best. From my side, if I get an opportunity, I'll also go all out to give the best what I have. So it's nothing to compare about for sure. But yes, if you see what men's are getting, I think now women's are also getting the same. So I cannot say there is much difference between men and women anymore.
Okay. How was the journey when the team went to Malaysia for the tournament? Like, describe to me some of the best moments in Malaysia, because I have personally read and also written lots of articles about it. So I just want to know, how was that journey in Malaysia, because that was the most recent one.
The recent one, I'm not sure, but Malaysia was my first.
Your first one, sorry. Yes.
Yes. So for me, it was my first assignment for sure. I was overexcited being at the head coach, and lot of popularity I was, because I was the first female, lot of media support I had that time. So for me, it was like to give my best. For me, it was like to encourage the girls, and, you know, we need to win this two matches. We were playing two matches, but then one was closed door and one was open. So for me, it was like we had to win. We want to win. And the same attitude I put it to the girls also. We have to win. We want to win. We need to win. It was all that. So I think at the end, if you see, the match was 0-0. My substitute who went in the 60th some minute, she scored the goal for the team.
During the second half,
So then we won the match. I think that was the best moment. And that I remember that substitute player was just waiting for me to, like, you know, change and make a substitution. Her name was Pyari. She's from Odisha. As soon as she scored, I could see her, like, she's like looking at me and saying, "Ma'am, I scored," and she was running towards me. So that was a moment what I could, you know, not forget for sure. And that was my career's first match as a coach and standing on the pitch there. So for me, that was definitely, you cannot forget those moments.
I think that match in Malaysia, I think, was the most crucial and the most important one, I think, in your entire career so far.
Because for me to get through as a head coach, I had to give a result, and the team had to win. And which really the girls made it, and then I was with the team for last now almost 2 years.
I think before we slip into a break, I would like to ask you, what was that those things that came in your mind when you were announced as the head coach, the first Indian woman to become a head coach of a women's team out there?
In fact, when I heard that from Federation, I got a call saying that you'll be this, and I really had no idea that I'll be the first woman to be the head coach. But yeah, for sure, I was excited and I was looking forward for it. And because earlier I'd worked under Sir Sharjit, so I was looking forward for it, and I thought I will, you know, go ahead and I will definitely help. Whatever I have, I'll definitely give it to the national team and things. But once it came out in the media, I was like, oh, I was the first woman. So for me, it was like a kind of a shock, and for me, it was a kind of a surprise. But yes, I was happy.
Yeah, I think on that note, we'll just take a small break and we'll be back to see some and hear some more interesting stories from Maymol. So keep watching Goa 365. We'll see you in a break. Welcome back, and we still have Maimol with us. So Maimol, coming back, how is the coaching experience going on till date? I think you became coach in 2017, right? And then till now,
yes,
the wave is there for India from you. So how is it going on?
There are a lot of pressure for sure, but I think I enjoy it, and now it's become like a daily thing when we need to plan things, we need to prepare things, we need to make schedule for the maybe day or maybe week or maybe month, and the staff is around who I have is also, you know, into it. So for me now it's become like, yes, we need to give our best every day, let it be the players or staff or anybody. Everybody's and nobody's confirmed in your places, so everybody needs to work hard to be where they are.
So how was it when now you became the head coach? How was the scenario with the girls out there? What was the excitement that you have seen from them when they realize that you have become the head coach, and also they will be training under you now?
I think once we started earlier, when I took in 2017, when I took the team, before that I was with the team till in 2016 also as an assistant coach. So I think that really helped me to be where I am today, how the girls could trust me, how I could understand the girls more with the senior team. I was with the age group from 2012 with under 16 D, but then I think that's a different age group and that's a different scenario, and that's a completely different thing when you are with the senior team. I think in that case, all Shajit sir really helped me to, you know, be with the girls and be around the girls. But I was sure that girls were a little more hesitating to talk to sir in few things. They should come and tell me, then I should put it up to sir in some situations and some places. So I think that way the girls had more kind of a trust. But as everybody knew in the media, there was quite a conflict between few players. But then I think at the end, if they realize what is right for them and what is right. For me, it was not my team. It was the nation. It was the national team.
Correct.
For me, I had to take some solid decisions, because otherwise it becomes difficult and things cannot be the same. You know, if you don't, for me, it was like if you play and you give your best, you will be in the national team. For my thing was very clear, straight and clear. Nobody is being treated as they have a seat in the national team. They are fixed for the national team. No. If you work hard, you be in the team. If you have an injury, you need to take rest, you need to step out. So for me, it was like that. But I don't know how this girl, few players were treated before, and they, for them, it was like, no. They will be in the national team throughout. For me, it was like, you give your best, you'll be in the national team.
Yeah.
So it's not you have a place in a national team when you will just sit or you want to play some walking football, for sure. So it's everybody works hard. So every player is treated the same. No seniors, no juniors, and that for me the thing. So there was quite a few conflict in between, but as soon as we started progressing, everything was in place, and I think the players came to know what is right for them and what is wrong, and they started joining the national team back. So for me, it was good that everybody follows a system, because nothing is taken for granted.
Correct.
Finally, I think at the end of the thing, if you see, the results follow. So everything has its own discipline, and the things what the players should do, they should do only that, not, you know, interfere in other things, for sure. But as football isn't so popular, and now women's team is getting more highlighted, things are happening. But then I think at the end of the day, I think players understood what is right and what is wrong, for sure.
Was there any pressure on you? Because we have seen, especially in India, there's more of, as I said earlier, football is dominated by the men. So was there that high-end pressure on you that you have to create a difference and come out with positive results?
If anybody, not me, being a female, if it was a male also, anybody takes up a national team, and I think everybody will have that pressure, for sure. For me, it was more, for sure. Because being a female, I had to compete with, you know, previous coaches and previous results.
Correct.
And everybody was comparing things. It was difficult, but then I think there was a lot of support from the staff, my family, my friends, my especially the players. For me, I was very open to the players. Players should know what is happening. So for me, I should be very open. I should tell the girls, we should have a lot of meetings, a lot of free talks, 1v1 talks most of the time. So players were quite open, and they knew what is happening and what is. So for me, it was, I think I was a kind of an open book, and everybody could, you know, read it. So it was quite open. Pressure was definitely there, being at this the highest post in the country. But at the end, I think the things were okay.
Yeah. So recently we also came across, you had the a press conference or a video conference with the AIFF president as well to discuss about the football, the future of football in India. So how was that? What were the main highlights that if you could elaborate on that?
The main highlight, first thing, he had like kind of a meeting with all the coaches who are in different age groups and teams, with the senior head coach also. So I was also a part of it, and he really welcomed us for the new year, what we started. But only thing, we could not meet him personally, as everybody knows the lockdown things were on.
Yeah, yeah.
But for sure, he praised the women's team and of course me, and the results what we had in this past years, and we were looking forward for the next year. So he asked me what are my plans and what we are looking forward. For sure, we are not sure when this lockdown will be over and things, and what the girls are doing. He wanted to know how the girls are keeping up with the situation and things. So it was quite healthy. I think being at the top position and the president of AIFF, getting talking to the coaches and keeping us in confidence, I think that was really good from Sir's part, for sure.
All right. So as you said about the lockdown, so how have you been in the lockdown, especially with your players, with those 22-24 girls? What are they doing? How are they?
The girls, definitely, first when it was lockdown, the girls were all completely back home and they were doing nothing, and then they slowly started activities, they started doing. So now we have a program done for the players, like they are all doing strength training, and now they started going onto the fields, and few things, a few players have started going to the fields, few are doing their rehab, few are doing with the conditioning coach, few are there at their centers. But I'm sure once they get back to the field, it'll be difficult for us, because the way we started the whole year of 2019 was together, and now being this lockdown and we had a long break, it'll be difficult once they start together and on the football field, because strength and conditioning, everything needs to be put up to football finally. So I think it'll be difficult, but nevertheless we are waiting and looking forward to start again as soon as possible.
As you said, you want to start as soon as possible. So there are lots of people who are, you have been their idol, you have been for them their guru, there are lots of people who are following you. There are personally, even I have seen from my own village or even from my friend circles, who they speak to me, and I have some football people in the other states as well, where they also told me, man, you have a coach from your area, we want to meet her, we want an autograph. There are lots of people who are you have become an inspiration to them. So what will be your message for the upcoming talents, especially the girls out there who will opt for their future, who want to do their future when it comes to football in India also?
For me, it's not, I cannot say it's only for the girls, it's for the boys also. I think it's all about your hard work and your interest. If you don't have this too, you will never succeed in future, in your career, in what you want to do. If you love doing what, please, if you love football, you can choose it as a career. If you love music, choose music as your sport. So what you love to do, I think that is the thing what you need to choose as your career. And I think for the girls, the most, the best part is, like, now a lot of opportunities are there, a lot of clubs are there, a lot of grassroots centers are there, a lot of jobs being open, railways are being, taking players. I think it's just your interest and hard work. Girls, go out and I think just give your best. Things will follow you for sure. I never thought I will be here, but I think I worked hard for it, for sure.
Yes.
So things will follow you. You don't have to go and beg for anything. You don't have to ask anything from anybody. Things will definitely follow you. And if you really work hard, I think God also cannot stop things what right. you are supposed to get.
And recently we have seen in Goa as well, there was a women's league that was organized, and we saw new talents coming out, which were, I think, hidden. They used to play only for their school and we couldn't see them. But do you think that such tournaments actually should be organized in future in different parts, so that the talent is seen? Because we have seen that scouting also sometimes is not done properly, So there are lots. So these tournaments, me personally as a journalist as well, I have actually seen new talents out there where we saw some few faces when we were in college, and maybe their friends who we knew were playing. But then later when these tournaments were held, we saw lots of new talent. So what do you feel about such tournaments?
For sure, I should say GFA was doing a great thing with the women's league, what they started on, for sure. As you said, there should be more tournaments. I will definitely agree there should be more tournaments, more small-sided games. Futsal should be on. I think football should be everywhere, every place and every corner of Goa, for sure. But I think I should tell all the clubs and teams or whoever are interested in women's football, they should take part and, you know, start with a women's team. In future, women's football will definitely raise and, you know, it'll be a bright thing what the club owners can really look up for. As you said, a lot of girls participated in the women's league.
Yes.
So it was GFA have done their part, they have organized one league. I think some companies, some private tournaments also should happen hand in hand. And if you see, I had been for a university tournament which happened in university ground, and Sir Milton had invited me as a guest for the finals. And I really selected one player for the national camp from the university finals. So for coaches like me, if I go around, I can see some tournament, I definitely stop and I watch if I can find somebody. So it's not that scouting is not done, for sure. In AIFF also now have started a scouting. We have a different scouting panel where all over India we have coaches or we have scouts who are doing scouting. Me personally, if I go anywhere around and I see women's football or girls playing, I definitely stop and have a look. So the girls can definitely, if something is happening, if somebody tells me also there is a match or something, exhibition, I just go sit quietly at a corner and I watch and I come back if I'm not a guest, for sure. So I think that the girls should never give up football. If they are interested, just work hard, keep playing, for sure. Yeah. So somebody will have a look.
I think on that note, I have only 30 minutes to discuss and I have almost come to an end. And on that note, where you said that keep fighting till the end, you said it like,
yes.
And you also said it, work hard. So I think on that note, on working hard, we will end this another edition of Sports Encounter. Well, thank you so much, Maimol, for being a part with Sports Encounter. We wish you all the very best and hope to hear more about you in media and also one day coming with another trophy and winning it for India as well. Thank you so much, ma'am, and wish you all the very best. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Keep supporting women's football. Thank you.
Yes, definitely. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.